All right, so here we are. Click back in the window, click back in all the windows. So yeah. But this game is a good example of, you see that mountain, you can one day climb it. There are some places that are intentionally gated off until you have your giant fighting flying robot, which... I made the unfortunate mistake of, when I first played through the game. Played through it, beat it, and then wanted to start another character to, like, do some other, to do some different stuff, like different builds and whatnot. Why is my compass pointing me this way? Good. Oh, hi! Let's zoom out. Get a better view. Anyways, the game only has one save file. And I didn't realize this until after I had saved over my previous game. That, had a lot of playtime on it. Where am I going? Oh! A nice nickname I have for this game is Mountain Goat Simulator 2015. Because they didn't really do a lot of putting slopes in. The title makes a lot more sense. Yeah. Also, hello, obscenely long username. How are you? But yeah, like, I just love the sense of scale that this game has. It's just like, yep, there's New LA. That's where we started. And we just ran out to this mountain over here. And there's Oblivia, the desert zone. Unfortunately, that's the only entrance. So, we're gonna go that way. See if we can't mountain goat our way up those rocks. Actually, I don't feel like mountain goating my way up those rocks, so I'm going to mountain goat my way over these rocks. Ah, Twitch delay. But yeah, one of the main methods of locomotion in this game is cheesing your way up cliffs. Also, these Grexes are going to aggro me, and it's going to be painful. Please don't look at me. As with any good MMO, you want to run past all the randomly high-level enemies that are in an area. Swim time! Woo! This game is just pretty. Like, that's really all it is. I just think this game is really pretty. We'll get into combat soon enough, and then take a look at how that works. There's a dude over there. Alex! Oh, hi. You! And so these are other players that are around, other people's avatars, and you can say, hey, join my team. A level 22, a duelist, cool. Yes, you can join my team. Boom. Ah! We were one person there for a second. But yeah, so now I've got... I mean, they're not actually playing. That's an AI controlling their avatar. But there are instances where you can actually go online and do, like, raids with other players. Which I think that's pretty neat. Once again, ignore the fact that I am playing as Undyne, but my name is Kara. Don't worry, everything's fine. Oh, loot over here. Oh, hey, fishman. Giant fishman. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. Oh. Oh, I don't think I have the tech to... Nope. I need to be better at archaeology to get that loot. Do the strangers on your team get any benefit for lending you their character? I believe they do. In fact, where am I? Okay. It's a shame that I can't also broadcast my touchpad, because you can fast travel via the touchpad. Also, yes, the jeans very much match the skin tone of this character. And so this is the multiplayer hub area. And so we'll... First we need to get a prize. Collect reward. We were rank 4 the prospectors yesterday. Let's fuel up. Well, I don't even have a scale yet. Intensifier. I like intensifiers. But yeah, so, like, this is the area where you can do, like, multiplayer missions and stuff, and then outside... Loading. Of the few loading zones that exist in the game, this is the worst. Not actually. I'm sure there are worse loading zones, I just can't remember them off the top of my head. So, over here... scout blades. And so this is where you can get people into your party, and then if your blade, your character, was used in somebody else's party, this button, you claim scout rewards, is highlighted. You get, like, money and experience and stuff if your blade was used by somebody else. What? That's my current... That's the person that people will... Okay. Anyways. But yeah, so there's a little bit of reward for having your avatar be used by other people. Alright, now then. Let's jump back to where we were. Because fast travel makes things very, very fun. No, that's not the word. Convenient. If anything, fast travel sort of removes a lot of the sightseeing. Removes one aspect of fun in exchange for another, I guess. Lets you get to the action quicker, but you don't get to, like, run around. Because sometimes just running around is fun. And now... quick shift over into the desert zone, Oblivia. Yeah, camera. Oh, squad tasks. So everybody playing on the server now has that little squad tasks bar where if you collect certain items, certain amounts of certain items within the time limit, everybody on the server gets a prize. And the prize is just like these little tickets that you can exchange for other items. Mission update. Wait, I have a mission to get what? Hey, sweet. Oh. Oh, that was for the... Oh. Wait, was that for the squad task? I don't even know. When with these collection missions, it doesn't actually tell you what you're trying to get, which is kind of lame, because sometimes the squad task will be like, kill certain enemies, and they'll have an icon over their head saying, hey, these are the ones you gotta kill. Also, pick up all the loot because... Oh, hey. Wow, people are on top of these. 17 reward tickets. That's a unique monster tromping its way over here. Please stop walking forward, Mr. Robot Man. Thank you. Oh, wait, no. I need to go through there. Well... Let's kill some bugs first. Okay, so. There's a lot that goes on during combat in this game. I suppose it's kind of similar to Xenoblade Chronicles, where you have your skills there at the bottom and they've got cooldowns. But the one thing... I suppose I can't really talk about what Xenoblade Chronicles does since I've never actually played it. But every so often, if certain conditions are met, your people do little like call-outs. And then if you answer the call-out with a skill that matches the call-out, the color of the call-out, you get a little bonus. You get healed and do some extra damage, or depending on what the call-out was, maybe, like, your attacks now have a status effect on it. I don't know, it's weird. But we're going to fight this unique guy. You can tell because he's got a purple circle around his name. Also, good music. Like, if you were wondering how anime the soundtrack is, here you go. Can I get a soul voice? There we go. Come on. Woo! Also, there's no, like, or very little. The soundtrack's a little quiet. Yeah, balance isn't, like, or audio balancing isn't something that they did very well in this game. That's one minor complaint I have. Because I'm fairly certain that even in the options menu... shoot. Cooldowns. Even in the options, you can't really do... audio balance. Also, there's very few... I guess this is just a gameplay mechanic that I have a gripe with. But there's very few actual healing spells. And these soul voices are your main method of healing. And so if conditions aren't met... To activate a soul voice, you just can't heal. I believe there's no way to change audio. Yeah, no. Which is real lame. I mean, I can turn up the game volume. But then I'm wondering if the game might be a little too loud. Please don't see me, robots. But yeah, all the... Well, can I... Let's see. Appearance, brightness, power... Because, yeah, there's no way to, like, lower the volume on all the character callouts for reasons. I'm not sure what those reasons are, but, you know. I'm sure they're good reasons. Okay. Now that we're infiltrating, an enemy alien base, I could just fast travel and make this a lot easier on myself. But where would the fun in that be? Oh. Metal Gear Solid. With the Metal Gear over there, stomping around. Also, I wonder if I'm not high enough level. Yep, need more archaeology for that. Well. Don't mind me. Alright, running time. Oh, well. Elma just exploded. Jump. Jump. Don't worry, we'll lose them on the switchbacks. See, we made it out of their aggro range. And we're all fine, and nobody died. Okay. Wait, there's a loot up there? Oh. That's probably alien loot that I need archaeology skill for. But my specialties are in mechanics and biology, which means I can't access alien technology for some reason. I don't know. Oh yeah, there he is. Oh, come on. Bye. Bye! Auto attacks hit you no matter what you do, and it's BS. Just keep running. Just keep running. We'll get out of their aggro range eventually. Yep. 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 Come on. Stop it. Okay. The number one skill in this game is noping out of battle. Because you get things like that that'll one-shot your party. And there's nothing you can do about it. Like, that guy doesn't aggro. Hartmut the Calamity. This guy doesn't aggro. But if you're in a fight on this bridge, and you use an AoE attack that so much as grazes him, rip your party. But yeah, so like, I don't know how you're supposed to fight this thing. Level 60 is the cap in this game. And even with, like, a fully pumped out super fighting robot, I'm not sure how to fight something like that. And there's a few of those guys. Yeah, the Calamity, stay far away from him. But yeah, there's, like, a few similar monsters that are just, like, so obscenely higher level than you can achieve. That I'm not sure why they exist. All right. Looking at the map, I need to get on the other side of this ridge. So we'll go around and hope these squirrels don't aggro. But I can kill these squirrels. They're easy enough. The reason that I ran away from all those aliens back there was because there were a lot of them. I probably could have taken them, but I didn't want to run the risk of just dying. What's this? Oh no, squirrels! Whee! I should probably... Eh, whatever. Oh, whoops. There's this weird balance that this game runs between wanting to use your skills because they're good. Ah, this is a mechanical wreck. Okay, cool. Between wanting to use their skills, your skills, because they're good and do a lot of damage, and wanting to not use your skills so that you can save them for if your allies do their soul voices so that you can heal in the middle of battle. And sometimes it's really frustrating when, you know, I use a skill because the soul voice hasn't triggered in a while, and then immediately they're like, oh, by the way, use a weakening attack, and I'm like, it's on cooldown. I mean, I would dig if this game was actually an MMO. I think it would be neat. Because, I mean, it's basically what it is. It's basically, at this point, just a single-player MMO. But, I mean, just so I can have a little more control over combat. That thing makes weird noises. Squirrels rolling around in the dirt. Please don't aggro. Thank you, squirrels. Alright. Approaching. Oh! Oh no! Later! Oh no! Yeah, it's not quite mass... Well, it's a massively not quite multiplayer game. I love your soundtrack, guy, but I need to get away from you. Oh, hey, Hartmut. Yes, if you ever encounter something with a purple level, you probably won't be able to take it out. You might through sheer luck, but yeah, that's one of those nope. Also, that there are enemies that are just hiding in the ground waiting for you to walk close so they can pop out. Alright. Quest time. Alright, we were delivering something to these guys. So the soundtrack, you have the soundtrack for the unique monsters, and then just the normal battle soundtrack. Alright, plot. Go kill the monsters!
If that's the case, we'd be happy to escort you.
Really? Wow! It'd be an honor to work with your team, ma'am.
Okay, yep. Talk, 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 talk. Talk, 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 talk.
Tatsu getting oddly similar vibe from these two.
Talk, 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 talk. Okay, right. Plot. Earth is destroyed. Yeah, kill the monsters, the staple of any MMO. Earth was destroyed by those aliens that we were running from earlier. Because reasons. Earth was in the middle of a galactic war between two warring factions in space. Somehow Earth knew that the war was coming. And so they established this project, Project Exodus, to go to the stars. To send generation ships off into space to hopefully save the human race from extinction. Spoiler alert, it didn't quite work. The aliens saw that humans were leaving Earth and followed us off into space. We got close to this planet, Mira, one of the ships, the White Whale, got close to this planet, Mira, was shot down, and the city of New Los Angeles has become our base of operations here on the planet Mira. So that's fun. And so now we're trying to, you know, like, survive on the planet. Head to the meeting point in front of Oblivia's giant leaning ring. Oh. I don't want to tangle with this bird. So I'm going to jump off the cliff. Oh, bad idea. No aggro. Farts. Farting skunk. Squirrel. I hate this, the you've been spotted intro, though. Like, I love the battle music, but there's that little riff if you get aggroed onto, and it's kind of annoying. Oh, it's this quest. Oh, I've had trouble with this one.
Understood. We'll handle the fighting. I'll call you once the area is secure.
Man, Elma's amazing. She's so strong and professional and beautiful.
Elma was a colonel in the United States Corps. Or in the,
Tatsu know how no need for shame about being ineffective and useless lump.
Thanks. Wait, who are you calling a useless lump?
And then there's Tatsu. He is a no-pawn. He is a native to this planet. He is the comic relief. And he does far too much relieving. Oh, wait, no, this is a is this? Hey, Crab! Get wrecked! I kind of want a different skill there. Oh, dang it. All right. Pew, 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 pew. Pew, pew, pew! And then you're like, man, these crabs sure were easy. I'm sure that nothing bad is also going to happen. I think this is, yeah, something bad is up there. Of course, yeah. I need to build up my TP, so I am not going to. Yeah, that's pretty much the our camera. Why is that crab on the wall? Wall crab. Climb the wall to get the crab. Yeah, I need to change around my skills. Also, there are times where I'm not sure if crippling specific appendages actually does anything. You got the flight module? Yeah, that's when the game really gets fun. Is once you get your Skell's flight module. Also, how you doing, Token? Nice of you to drop in. Sovereign blessings. You're looking good, guy. looking good. Yeah, your skills refresh after every combat. Doing good. That's awesome. Alright. Let's head into the middle of this big open field where we need to plant this data probe. Because nothing bad's gonna happen at all. Yep.
Wow, you carved through those guys like butter. That's amazing.
Yep.
Get right on installing the data probe, man.
And we'll keep an eye on the area so you can focus on your work.
Boop, 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 boop. I do find it interesting that the giant robots aren't actually designed for, or that only certain of the giant robots are actually designed for combat. A lot of them are designed for just like manual labor and construction jobs. But then some of them were repurposed for combat.
Holy crap! Simon, we gotta get out of here!
Go if you want.
which I just think is neat. Oh, right. Yeah. They, by nature of being a giant robot, they are fairly fine at combat. But, nothing's getting past me. Right, also, spoiler alert, everybody on Earth died. Even the people who were on the white whale. Turns out, we're all just robots, and our consciousnesses are remotely piloting these robot bodies from this thing called the life hold that is currently lost. And that's what we're trying to find. Like, in recovering all these artifacts and all the stuff, we're specifically trying to find this life hold. Oh gosh! So that we can, you know, not die. Oh, we're silenced. It is kind of a confusing plot, yes. Did that guy just Starfinger? Yeah, I remember this being a terrible fight. Doesn't help that Elma and Lynn are woefully under-leveled. I need to build. Yeah. Why? What? Oh, and that just shuts down all of my attacks. Wow. That's kind of bull honky. Or maybe it just shuts down my beam attacks. Well. Oh, and my friend left. Well. Well. What do I have in my inventory for usables? HP, Tensifier. I might need to use those. Okay. We're gonna go back in. We're gonna go back in, and we're gonna fight this thing, and I'm gonna use some of these consumables. Although I suppose that doesn't help much if Elma just got one shot. Actually, party arts me. Alright, changing my stuff. Rondo. I think I like the Rondo better than that other thing. Geolibrium gives me HP regen, but I might want... No, I like Geolibrium. Astral Protection? Oh, no, I like Astral Protection. Recovers HP when using arts. Astral Heal is a good one because it is just a cure spell. But let's put on Astral Purge because it removes debuffs, and I hope that it can be cast through whatever the garbage that Leaping Claw attack was. Another, I guess, myth complaint that I have about the combat system in the game is, I suppose, I've been spoiled by games like Final Fantasy XIV and some such, and other such MMOs where you can actually see Alright, well thanks for stopping by, obscenely long username. You have a good day. Where you can, like, see the area of attack and you can actually, like, physically dodge it. But no such anything in this game. Recover when using a buff, boost the HP recovery of members you revive, boost potential, beam damage, buff extender. Lin's just got stuff. Actually, Lin, now that you've leveled up, I want you to have this. I want you to have this. Token's still here. That's good. I need you to max out that topple. That long topple. And then I need you to equip everything that inflicts topple. Which is just wild down. That's not great. Move out Flame Cloak for cool off. You have Reality Rift. Yeah, wild down. Wow, really? She only has one thing that inflicts topple? Okay. Well, hopefully she's smart enough to use it. And then Elma, what do you have? Shadow Strike, Sliding Slinger, Stream Edge, Upper Hand, Early Bird, Side Slash. Thirsty Edge. You might actually want that. Killing Machine? Maybe. I definitely don't need you to have Blood Sacrifice. That's for certain. But you've already got three skills that use TP. You have so many skills that use TP, goodness. Alright, well, let's see what happens. This friend. Hey, you. Level 19? Alright. That did nothing! Oh gosh. Let's get some heals. It's a shame the only way to get these consumables is, Wow, I am just severely underleveled. Really? Ah, shoot. I wish I actually knew how Overdrive worked. And that I didn't just use it to spam all my attacks. Oh, now it's raining. Man, Elma. I'm out of tensifiers. He's easy to beat. Yeah. I mean, it's not tough, it's just... the rest of my team is, under-leveled, we'll say. Lynn, why aren't you doing anything? Good. Steel Flesh? Yeah, but I have to go be a Bastion Warrior. Or a Shield Trooper to learn Steel Flesh. And Lynn has that maxed out, and well, there she goes. That's about it. Yep. Yeah. Skills. Cause yeah, I don't have Steel Flesh. Gravity Guard, no. Boost potential, boost beam damage, boost recover HP when receiving a buff. Boost max TP, blah, 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 blah. Yeah, Lynn has Steel Flesh. Lynn has Steel Flesh maxed. She also has Shield Screen, which, if she would stay with her shield, would be fine. The class that I am... Galactic Knight. Which I could just go grind out, like, if I had all the time in the world, which I don't. I could just grind out up to Bastion Warrior and get Steel Flesh. Or go over with Astral Crusader, because Astral Crusader is a fun class. Mix of offense and defense improves melee and ranged attack. I'm not sure, like, what this class is supposed to do. Yeah, that's why. Yeah, this seems like a support class. But of course, I was just starting at the bottom and gonna work my way up. This is very much a support class. The duelist only gets 3 skills. Yeah. Yeah, the Bastion Warrior, the shield trooper Bastion Warrior, is definitely the tank. They are very good at not taking damage and having life so that if they take damage they don't die. Unfortunately, I think I've made a boo-boo, but you know, we live and learn. Now then. Wrong buttons. You know it's bad when you can't navigate menus. Right, this stuff. Spherical EM rotor. Right, gotta get stuff for L. I think I have Meranium. Let's go do some side quests, because we obviously can't do this yet. I'll have to do stuff on my own time. Oh man, gotta actually. Using the map to fast travel. Wait, no. Gotta go to the administrative district. Click this button. Go to the Blade Tower. Yeah, it's things like that where you have these different classes that, like, you've got a support class, you've got a DPS class, you've got a tank class, you've got the debuff class. Like, you've got these classes that do all these wildly different things. But it's not common that you're playing with other people. And so it ends up that just like one or two of them are actually good in single player. Oh, right, the Manon. I love their voices. Hmm. Here's some dank Maymay. Stop that. Oh, the man on ship. If you ever wanted an example of, like, technobabble, affinity mission called Manhunt. Is that one of Yelv's? It sounds like it'd be one of Yelv's missions. I never did complete his affinity quest. Cool. He was a cool guy. Maybe it's Fog. You! Take this loot! Yes, take this loot and give me cash and experience points. And I guess affinity also. Sure. What other quests do I have going on right now? Noctilum Trailblazing? Ooh, right. Ooh, right. That one. Strip plating from Pugoliths. Quality fuses from Pugoliths. Oh. Bose's quest. Oh yeah. Oh. Oh. Oh yeah. This game does have, I think this game's got a wonderful soundtrack. Although I suppose in the case of the man on ship, it's kind of a slow burn to get to the point where you get the cool beats. And then you go to NLA at night and you're just like, why? Huh? Oh. How do you like the ride? Orb device packs a kick, yes. The man on her trying to learn human culture. Because it's always funny to watch aliens try and learn human culture. Go hunt some things. Alright, I will go hunt some things with these guns that you have given me, so that I may be advertisement. I just hate the voice modulator they used for the man on. Oh, NLA nighttime theme. Alright, well. Rip in pieces! Ho! Sploosh. Everything's just so big. Alright, enough splooshing around, I gotta go to the hangar. Fast travel for ease of travel. Yes. Sure. Oh, I still got this guy following me. You! Wait, are you the racist? No. Oh yeah, 40 pieces of an Arcean Orwood. Sure. Come on! An Arcean Orwood is a rare material. It's found in, like, one spot in Primordia. Oh wait, no, I need to do the quest for Tutura. Or I need to do the quest for somebody, and that somebody, like, then comes back and is like, OBT dubs, I can... Sure. The guy's like, hey, I can do it for cheaper. Because technology! Oh, no. No, no, it's just accepting the quest. It is inefficient, you only need one Nokomira stone. And then the guy's like, hey, you stupid alien. I remember there was one quest with, like, a horribly racist person. I mean, that sounds kind of bad when I put it like that, but... It's actually, like, you know... interesting to... It's like actually afraid of aliens. Wants to murder them all, and you're just like, that's not good. You are a bad man. Cool. I don't know. There's a lot of interesting stories that go on in this game. You got loot. Now we fast travel back to the hangar. Talk. Take loot. And then this guy's like, hey, that's cool. You did it. And the guy's like, our technology's the best in the universe. And it's like, bye, you little weirdo. Oh. And then we get to go on a quest to back and forth. I think another one of the complaints that I hear a lot about this game is that you aren't the main character. Maybe it's not a complaint. I swear I've heard it somewhere. Pizza. Have pizza. Stop saying cool. Anyways, but like, it's an RPG where you're not the main character. You're the protagonist and the point of view character. But the story's not about you. It's about humanity as a whole, which I think is neat. Sure, give me a hot dog. I've got $2 million to spend.
No kidding.
Where?
Just between us.
Hey. Yeah, give me pizza. And then I have to wait for daytime, even though I know it's pizza the man on want. Because for some weird reason, they're alien palates.
Damn it.
Find that specific bench that I can sit until daytime. Sometimes I ramble and don't really have a point and never finish my thoughts. Gimme hamburger. Boom. And then I travel back to the man on ship. Because I'm the errand person. A giant mortiful that lives on top of the twin arches. Cool. Jeez. Give pizza. Nothing matters except pizza. the culinary jewel of the cosmos. Even the Destroyer King, whose wrath rent planets in twain, would bow before the sheer force of this deliciousness, would he not? I give thanks that I was born. I thank you, Mother. Thank you, Father. I have a similar reaction whenever I eat a pizza. Oh, it's so bad. We enslaved the man on with pizza. And not just any pizza, specifically frozen pizza. Alright, well, that's the end of that quest line. For now. Backup request? Right, Bose. That's a neat quest. However, I think... Wait, do I have something else I can be doing? Handyman on. Right, I need stuff. I need stuff. Let's just go to Noctilum. I like running around Noctilum. Although, I think Silvalum is my favorite area in the game. This game is just so pretty. Wait, there's something over here I haven't gotten? A car? I didn't know I was playing Final Fantasy XV. Well. Near the elephant's trunk. Is it down? It's probably down. Oh wait, no. It was back up there. Yeah. Whoop. One by one. Oh, there it is. It's that little red pip. Got it. One by one. Whoa, see the sun. I like this game. I do. But that's going to do it for me for the day. Thank you very much to everyone who watched and chatted and various other stuff. This is... I don't know, this seems like a very unnatural sitting pose. Let's try sit two. Yeah, sit two is better. Anyways. But yes, thank you for watching. I will be back probably on Thursday. I'm trying to get back onto a schedule. There we go. No UI to clutter anything up. I'm trying to get back onto a schedule for regular streaming. my schedule before was Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday. It really worked for me, so I think I'm going to be sticking with that. But yeah, I don't really have anything else. Thank you very much for watching. I'll be back on Thursday about the same time. I started 3 hours ago, so about that time. I'll be sure to tweet out. I do have a Twitter that I tweet out on before I go live. But yeah. So let me just zoop. Thank you very much for watching. And y'all have a nice day.